Oh, my goodness. My goodness. What an SUV.
I've only driven it about 3 miles to get to here. I'm in love. I can tell you what I'm not doing in today's vlog is spending an hour or two walking around this car. Look at this, look at that, because it's 90 freaking 5 degrees, 102 humidity. I'm gonna zip around the outside so you can see it, and then I'm getting my ass in it, getting the air on, and we're gonna start driving this thing because it is, oh my God. I want this car. I absolutely want this car. The 2019 Maserati Levante Trofeo, and it is absolutely something special. Fiat Chrysler Automobiles, they spent 7 years designing this car. It wasn't some wham bam, thank you ma'am, slap it on the assembly line, get the hell out of here. No, 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 no. A lot of time, effort, research, love, care went into making this Levante Trofeo. And there's a touch of Ferrari in there too. I'm not gonna be able to do it justice. There's no way. There's so much technology that's in this vehicle. We'll cover the basics, and then we're getting out of this heat and we're getting in this bloody car. We're gonna start driving it. Now there's only one option on it. It's a little bit of carbon. Other than that, the whole car is just decked out. You get the Maserati Levante Trofeo and it's ready to go. But you better have 180 grand on you. One of the best looking front ends on any car anywhere. Love the Maserati emblem. Absolutely gorgeous. Adjustable headlights. There are your LED headlights. And they actually adjust three settings as you corner, which is a great touch with Maserati. There are your 21-inch rims, six-piston Brembo braking system. Very nice setup, very nice setup. I haven't actually tested the brakes yet, but we will. There is your rear. So a very nice braking setup, and you'd want that for 590 horsepower. Good looking tail end. There are your carbon fiber exterior package pieces. Here are your functioning heat extractors on the lightweight aluminum hood. You're not gonna wanna miss this. It's bloody off its head. Bloody hell. There is your carbon fiber accents on the front splitter. And right next to the intakes here. Very nice, very nice. Beautiful door handle. Frameless doors. Very hard to do on an SUV because of cockpit sound. But that's what 7 years of engineering will do. Just the glass. Look at the attention to detail. I mean, really? Alcantara headliner, Alcantara pillars, dry exposed carbon fiber on the inside. Oh my gosh, let's get in this thing. It's time to get the air going. I think I'm getting dehydrated. Man, I've become soft. I've become the softest. Woo! Ride height, park brake, hazard lights, infotainment system controls, here, here, and here. Here is your dampening system, sport or race mode. Corsa stands for race in Italian. Here is your ICE mode, and that stands for increased control and efficiency. Off-road, traction control. 8-speed automatic transmission with manual mode, and you have your paddle shifters either side that are fixed in place, which is a great touch. Here is your instrument cluster. Again, 42 miles on this car. It is brand new. Here is your 8.4 inch Maserati Touch Control Plus panel, infotainment system, Apple CarPlay, Android, all that sort of stuff, XM Sirius radio, blah, blah, blah. Here is the dual pane panoramic sunroof, and it's massive and it's beautiful. The back seat and no less attention to detail back here. I tell you what, it's first class wherever you're sitting. And it's actually
it's quite roomy. I've pushed this seat back quite a way so I can film in the front. It's actually very roomy back here.
All right.
Time to roll.
This is unbelievable, this car.
It's so satisfying. It's like, it satisfies my every need. This 3.8 liter V8 twin turbo engine is one of the best sounding engines when you plant your foot. Oh my God, that is so satisfying. That is so satisfying. Listen to it. Oh God, oh my goodness. Is there anything better? Honestly, the sound of a V8 engine, I just love it. I absolutely love it. I mean, I don't know if I'll ever catch on to the electric thing, but I tell you what, this is a masterclass. This car is just perfect. There is just nothing not to like about this car. Now, we can't use the race mode or track mode because the engine has to have at least 500 miles on it before we can engage track mode, which is a very smart piece of engineering because you don't want to damage the transmission, the engine. You want to let all components marry to each other before you start really pushing this twin turbo V8, and I tell you what, you can feel every bit of that 590-ish horsepower. It's phenomenal. It handles around corners. Oh, my goodness. My goodness. What an SUV. Seriously. What an SUV. Listen to it. I can't imagine this thing in track mode. Oh my goodness. Absolutely gorgeous, this car. I ain't messing with the infotainment system because I could give a crap about that, honestly. Fuel mileage, whatever. Who cares? I mean, really. Okay, sports suspension mode on. Let's test the suspension a little. So we'll slow down a bit. So nice, so responsive. Oh, and the brakes. Man, she. This thing, I want one of these. I absolutely want one of these. I think it's the perfect vehicle. Obviously, I was gonna say for a family, but you gotta have a bit of the old coin, if you know what I mean. But it is the perfect family vehicle. There is plenty of space in the back. Plenty of space. Like, it's just got so much space. There's no blind spots either. This is what I love about this thing. Like, I just don't have any blind spots. Everything is so visible in this car. They've done such a good job. Even looking out the rear window, which you can see, even with the headrests back there, there's just still plenty of visual aspect and ratio in this car. I tell you what, it was so worth standing my ass outside all day sweating just to be able to review this thing. Oh my gosh, it's phenomenal. I mean, it really is phenomenal. I freaking love this car. I love it, absolutely love it. Yes, it's a very expensive car. Well north of 100 grand. Maybe only 3-5% of North America can afford a vehicle at this expense. I don't know what the leasing price is on one of these. I don't even know if you can lease one of these. I wouldn't know what the payments on one of these would be. They'd be freaking high. But if I had the ability financially to buy something in this price range, I've driven several cars in this price range. This would have to be, I'd say, one of the top ones, if not the top choice. Here's something else I love about this car. When you drive, this little digital display here brings up every sort of road sign, school warning zones, speed limits, everything that you can think of. Let me know I'm in a 45 mile an hour zone right now. A school zone just popped up. I mean, this car has thought of everything. Overall, my experience with this Maserati is just, I don't have a bad thing to say about it. I don't. I mean, literally everything that I care about in the car, it encompasses, and it has, and it does it to an amazing level. Like, they've really set the bar for mid-size to smaller SUVs. Maserati have just knocked it out of the park. We are about to pull back into Bluegrass Motorsport, specifically Maserati and Alpha of Louisville. Thank you, CJ. Thank you, everyone at Bluegrass Motorsport. I love you guys. Best car dealership going around. I can't thank you enough for loaning me this absolute treasure today. It's the perfect car. Be sure to like, subscribe, comment, blah, 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 all that sort of bullshit. I'll leave all of Bluegrass Motorsport's information below. Get on their website, check out their inventory. They've got everything. But until next time, my friends, I appreciate you tuning in. Abracadabra, this vlog is over. ...2019 Maserati Levante Trofeo, and you're joking, right? Oh,
Oh my God.
The 2019 Maserati Levante, you're freaking joking, right? Let's just get real. Aye. You really actually have to see it in person and take it for a trip. This would be a very, very, I don't know. That is the day in the 2019 Maserati Levante Fioro, or whatever it is.
You'd think, being from Australia, I could handle the heat.
And we've got some chaos going on here in the road. It's just a box, love. Drive around it.
What do I got, a plane GPS on me, and everyone's got a, it's like Pokemon, they got to find me on these planes? Like, come on now. Why do I always pick 90 degree days to do reviews? Maserati of Louisville. And that is what they gave me today. That was stupid. Bellissimo. Crazy.